watch what the body does, right? Watch what the eyes do, the head does, and the body does. And anytime you want to see what a dog is relatively thinking or how out of control they are, you watch what they're looking at, you watch their body. So these, like, when the dog is exiting and keeping the dog in the peripheral as they're exiting, and everything is from the side, keeping tabs on the dog, like they call it, you know, sort of whale eyes, but it's essentially just a dog keeping tabs on a thing that it's insecure about, that it's worried about. And then in some cases, when it's a close proximity, and it's stiff and then side eyeing, that's typically a strike position. They'll come, it's almost like a dog sucker punch. They'll come off of the side and tag a dog. So you wanna be really careful with side eyeing of any kind. She has the ability to walk back up to Boo. She was a little bothered by Boo, had a hard time reading body language, got overstimulated. Immediately was overstimulated and trying to feed it onto the grass. So that I do believe that this is displacement behavior. And I do believe that any and all stimulation and drive, overstimulation, drive, etc., is fed into this little obsessive misplaced behavior, which can be really unhealthy. Because again, if she's catching dopamine as a motivator and feeding it into eating and snapping at bushes, it will become her main mission in life, the most important thing to her. Just like with anything, when we motivate a dog to do something, whether it's with treats, whether food or toys, and we encourage that interaction and we reward it, that dopamine spike is what perpetuates the "this is good, I like this, let's keep doing it," right? So the same thing for the environment when it creates a dopamine spike, which is why a lot of superficial reactivity gets really worse, because the dog will catch dopamine from it and then it becomes rooted.